Okay. Howdy, horse people. Talk about a few things here. First, look at the pretty picture of the lady with the cheetah. Oh, how cute. She's smiling. We'll get back to that. I'm going to talk about doing some hills. I went riding with a buddy of mine, and we were doing some hills, and he hasn't ridden his horse a lot, so I was expecting his horse not to do that great, but I noticed some things that he was doing that prevented his horse from doing as well as it could have. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about doing hills with your horses, on how to do hills and how to get your horse down a hill. You use the same techniques for hills, for water, for round pinning, for lunging, for handling. It's all the same. So I get a lot of emails saying, will you do a video about helping your horse with water? Or do a video about that. They're all the same. Everything that you do is small steps, little things. I've done a couple videos, I think, on hills where I'm riding Buddy. And today I'm going to use my whiteboard. Where's my whiteboard at? There's my whiteboard. And I'm going to use little Buddy, who's going to help us out here. But before we do that, I'm going to, somebody had put Team Buddy on some of the comments. I thought it was kind of cute. I think that's a Twitter thingy. I'm not sure, but I think every time I see Twitter somebody, they put a pound sign and they put a name. So I guess that's Twitter Team Buddy. I don't know. Maybe I'll try and get that Twitter account. So anyway, we're going to go back to the lady with the camera here, and I'm going to talk about a few things today. So as you see this lady here with this picture, she's taking a picture with a cheetah. Very nice. Okay? Also very stupid. She climbed over the freaking fence at a zoo to get this picture. Of course, there was my battery saver. So she climbs over the picture to get this picture with the pretty cheetah. Oh, Rick, isn't that nice? Cheetahs are such loving animals. They're wonderful. Yeah, they're wonderful, okay? So now we're going to go back, and we're going to move up to the headline of this article. And I'll put a link to this article. Oh, the mean cheetah attacks poor lady. Well, what the hell did you expect, you dummy? You're climbing over the fence trying to take a picture with a wild animal. This is the mentality to give people in trouble with horses. Oh, look at the pretty horsey. Hey, that horse just kicked my head off. I didn't know horses kick. Oh, look at the pretty mama with the baby. Oh, isn't that... Hey, mama just tried to bite my face off. What's wrong with that horse? That's what horses do. They bite when they protect, when stupid humans get around them. So here's another tip for all you loving horse people. Oh, Rick, I just love animals. They're so furry and soft. Well, guess what? Cheetahs attack. Shocker. I know there's a lot of people, they're not going to believe it. They're going to say, come on, Rick, you're making this up. No, seriously. Cheetahs attack and they bite. And they have claws and they scratch. If you read this article, this one claw, I think, almost took out her eye. I couldn't read it because I was laughing too much. Oh, Rick, you're just mean. You don't like women. Cause I had another article where a man climbed over and a cheetah attacked it, but I used the woman one just to keep all my woman haters. All right, people. All right, I'm going to get back to my computer here in a minute. Let's go over to Team Buddy. Oh, wait a minute. Before I go to Team Buddy, I have a little sign that this is an old Halloween costume, and I thought I would just add this phrase here. Barn witches are here. And now we'll zoom out to the... Oh, I'm going to get a lot of good love on this. Oh, you freaking women haters that want to be saying I'm hating on women. This is a man's butt. Anyway, barn witches are here. So we'll get back to that, too. But let's get to doing this whiteboard training with Buddy. Now, with my artistic ability, used to be an artist in another life. So that is a heel with two deep sides. And the problem with heels is, we get a little buddy here to help out. What people want to do when they get a horse down a hill is they want to make him go straight down, which means the horse has to drop his butt in order to slide down so he stays level. And if you're not being a good load here and you're like this and you're leaning forward and not leaning back, staying neutral, no matter which way a horse goes, your body and legs should stay straight. So if a horse is going downhill, it's going to look like you're pushing your stirrups forward, but you're not. You're staying straight and balanced. So when a horse goes level, you're still staying straight and balanced. And when a horse goes uphill, it looks like I'm leaning forward and I'm pushing my heels to his back, but I'm not. I'm staying level. This is me. This is me. This is your legs. This is where barn witches are. This is how a horse, you want to stay on a horse. A neutral balance. Horse goes down, you stay neutral. Horse goes up, you stay neutral. A horse turns, you stay neutral. If a horse goes down a hill like this and you're trying to lean, you throw him off balance because you think your legs are supposed to be straight. So you try to keep him in the same position. Horse goes like this. Now all your weight's pulling the horse over his head. That's nervous. That makes a horse stressful. That's not good for a horse. That creates stress, pressure. It confuses the horse because when you do this, you're probably pulling on his head. So his head's going down. So he can't use his head. Oh. I didn't know how to make that thing do that, but it makes a noise if you touch something. Anyway, be quiet, buddy. Buddy's always got to be active up. So when a horse goes downhill, you want to stay neutral. Up, down, level, down, cantering, trotting, walking. Your legs stay straight. So when doing heels, a horse will naturally not want to do this, this, and then this. It's just natural for him to go here and go, I can jump over. Why do I want to waste this energy? Why do I want to go down here where it's more dangerous? Why do I want to go down here where I can't see predators that will come over and attack me, kind of like the cheetah? See, a horse knows the cheetah. You ain't going to see a horse over there trying to take a picture. Oh, look at the pretty cute cheetah. Well, buddy might. But most horses aren't going to do that because I know they're going to get eaten. Humans do it because they're stupid. So when a horse goes down here, it's not natural for them to be where they can't see out. They know that's a trap zone. That's a danger point. It's a choke. It's bad to be down here because predators, I can't see where the predators are. I don't know what I'm touching to get this. Oh, I don't know if you can even hear that. So anyway, when you're going down... When you're going down a hill, your job is to keep the horse straight, hit his head where you want him to go. If you teach your horse how to follow his head, everything becomes easier. The problem is people use a bit, they pull on the horse goes, ow, that hurts, and then they make a horse turn this way. He's not following his head, he learns to go away from his head instead of tilting his head and making him go this way like you do with a rope halter. Or Bozell, but what people want to do is they want to use a bit, they pull hard, they try to pull the horse goes, ow, okay, I'll turn to get released, but it's wrong. A horse should follow his head. So when you're going down hills, if your horse follows his head, he's going to follow the path you take him. So when you're coming to a hill such as this, instead of trying to get your horse to go down, he gets nervous, he doesn't want to drop his butt, and all of a sudden he goes, poop, and he jumps. And then the person either falls off and goes, oh, I wasn't expecting that. Oh, my horse tried to throw me. No, you're a dummy. You weren't ready. You didn't read the horse. I can tell before a horse jumps, he squats. I know what he's going to do. But people get so focused on trying to get him to go down the hill, they forget to give him their head or to follow their head. So the horse gets halfway down. Then it says, you know what? I don't want to follow down. I'll jump. And when they jump, if you're not ready, buddy, I can't even keep a stuffed animal buddy quiet. I'm going to change his name to Mr. T so I can beat his butt. So anyway, when you're going down a hill, don't try to do this. This is a more advanced maneuver. Straight down, walk, straight down. What I want to do is, one, I want to get my horse used to walking down on the bottom so he has a heel on both sides. and he learns to walk without seeing over his head. He learns to trust me and follow me. The other thing I want to do is when I want to come down this hill, if this was a hill leading to the camera, instead of going straight down, maybe causing my horse to jump, and he won't go down because the straighter down he goes, the more he has to drop his butt, the more the rider has to be in the right position to help him drop his butt, and that will help him go down. If I get my horse to walk down here in a straight path with heels on both sides, then I get him to walk up an angle like so. So if this is an angle, and I don't know if I can, let me see if I can get to see this. So if this is an angle of where I'm going, I want my horse to walk up the angle at an easy uphill. I don't want him to get here and go, ah, and jump out. That's what people do. That's what horses want to do. Horses want to get to an angle, and if you want to come out, they want to go straight up. Well, if you're not a good rider and you don't keep your balance, you'll end up pulling them down, or they fall, they can't get up, they lose their balance, they trip and they fall. But if I make him walk sideways up this hill, he feels more secure. I have control over his nose. I don't let his head face straight up and go up. I don't let him go straight up. I prevent him. What I see a lot of people when they do it is they're walking, they want to try this, and the horse goes, you're not giving me good enough direction, so I'm jumping straight up. So, walking down this hill would be at an angle like this, and then walk down, and then come up like this. And then go down like this, walk straight, and then come up this way. Not this. This is not the right way to train a horse to do hills. It makes them nervous. They get scared. They can't do it. Now, if you don't have control of your horse, you're not going to get him to go down like this. Because you're going to get here, and he's going to throw his head up here and come back up. You're going to get here, he's going to lose his balance, he's going to pull back up. You're going to say, Rick, my horse don't do hills. Can you help me? No, I can't. You're a dummy. Your horse is telling you you're not doing it right. Listen to the horse. Don't write me and ask me. Listen to your horse. So, when Buddy's down here and he's walking straight, I want to slowly tilt his head, be ready to pull him back down, because when I tilt his head, I think I'm in the camera, when I tilt his head this way and he starts going up this hill, I have to be ready for him to turn so I can pull back and go, no, you can't go that way. So that's just learning feel and control. So when you're doing heels, hi buddy, is that thing even, well that looks awful dark, but whatever. Anyway, that's talking about heels. Let me get Buddy back up here. Good boy, Buddy. You're a good boy, even though you wouldn't shut up. So, let me get my thing back here. One last thing for Buddy. New trick I taught Buddy. So, now, I'm going to leave that on that nice visual for all you people. I'm going to come back over here to my computer and figure out what the other topics I want to talk about. I'll put a link to the tiger or to the cougar making friends with her new friend, the lady, her new friend, the little cheetah made friends with her. There'll be a link to that. I got this question today that I'm about to delete. But these are the kind of questions that just irritate me to death. Hi, Rick. I've been watching your videos. I'm going to turn around so you guys can hear the speaker in case I'm talking backwards. I've been watching your videos, and you give me a lot of answers. Really, obviously not enough because you're writing me. And obviously not enough because of the question you're asking. So I bought a Palomino quarter horse gelding, about 9 years old. Aw, ain't that sweet? She bought her a Palomino just like Buddy. Aw. Whatever. He is broke to ride. Right there, her comment tells me she don't listen to what I say. She don't read my website. She don't listen or watch the videos. He is broke to ride. That's about a signal, red flag, no natural horsemanship, old cowboy telling dumb people what they want to hear comment. Oh yeah, this horse is broke. He's dead broke. He's been so broke. He like a broke down old truck. He's broke, dead broke. Yeah, okay, you're an idiot. And anybody that listens to you is an idiot. Oh, by the way, before I forget, the dummy on the cheetah attack that I showed at the beginning, her husband, I don't know if he's a dummy or if he's smart. You can be the judge. When the cheetah attacked, he kept taking pictures. So I'm sure he's going to get his own little tacking when he gets home. But anyway, he might have told her not to go in there. I said, you're being stupid. And she went, he goes, okay, I'll just take pictures. Because that's what I do. If somebody told me they know horses and they don't need to listen to me and they understand horse, they rode it, I'd be, okay, I'll just take pictures. Go on in there. So anyway, then again, I'm not married to him. I have to go home to him like this dude does. All right. Hi, Rick. Been watching your videos. You answer a lot of questions. So I just brought a Palomino. I just bought a Palomino quarter horse gelding about 9 years old. He is broke to ride. He is a really sweet boy. Aww, you know if she's writing that, she knows what she's doing. That just tells me she's so smart. She can tell a sweet horse when she sees it. Freaking idiots. I tacked him up today. Okay, she don't tell me how long she just bought him, but she just tacked him up. I got on him. Marvelous. He seemed like he wanted to bolt. Gee, that's a shocker. And he wouldn't sit still and kept going in circles with me on him. Okay. These are all red flags, cues. These are all, this girl's probably a trainer. She just didn't want to tell me she was a trainer. I'm not going to lie. Well, that's good, because you've already said so many stupid things now. I'm scared now. Are you kidding me? You freaking buy a horse that you don't know shit about because he's broke. He's 9 years old. You're going to write me, tell me you watch my videos and I answer a lot of questions. And now you're scared of a horse after you bought it. And you want to write me? Ugh. Okay, I'm not going to lie. I'm scared now. I don't know what to do. Why is he acting like this? Please give me suggestions. If you'd have listened to my suggestions, you wouldn't have bought the damn horse without knowing all this. Obviously, you didn't do any of your homework. You didn't do your research. You don't say how old you are. If I had to guess, I'd say you're 14. But you're probably 39 and rode horses as a kid and loved them. And now you want to get back into them. Either way, you're just as stupid. I'm sorry if you're 13. I don't think you're 13, but whatever. If you are, you should have told me your age. I can't tell when somebody emails me how stupid they are because they all sound the same. I don't care if they're 50, 30, or 10. All the emails sound the same. I love them, and I don't know what, and please help me. I got another email from this other dummy today saying, if you don't help me, my horse is going to the slaughter. I've asked 10 different trainers, and none of them will work with me. You know what that tells me? You've pissed off 10 trainers because they know you're a freaking idiot and they don't want to work with you because you're a liability. You probably got no damn business with the horse. So now you're writing me, wanting me to fix your problems over an email after 10 trainers in person have seen that you're an idiot and now you expect me to help you. That would make me an idiot, okay? And the verdict's still out on that. But right now, I'm pretty sure the verdict's not out on you. It came back. So, anyway, This woman wants to ask me for that stupid question, which just irritates me, which I'm not going to answer. I'm going to delete. So hopefully she'll see this since she's watching all my videos. There's another video that I'm going to put on here. A lady sent me of some reining trainer. This is a female. The video is really bad. If you want to click on it, you can. It shows this woman kind of beating a horse because he don't want to go in a stall. I can't imagine why a horse wouldn't want to go in a dark stall, but obviously this woman who's a trainer knows why. And she kind of beats the crap out of the horse in the hallway. This lady's videotaping her, and supposedly she passed herself off as a trainer. You can watch the video. I'll put a link. It'll say woman trainer beating horse in a stall or something. So if you want to go to that link, you can. And what's the other one that I want to put? Oh, yeah. Somebody else has been sending me this thing, being a pain in the butt. I've already talked about this before. I'm not sure which video. There's a thing called the suicide race. I've had a lot of emails on it. It's stupid. Obviously, I disagree with it. Somebody's going to write me an email and ask me, what do you think about suicide race? Well, it's where you race horses straight down. I'll put a link to the video in the description. Basically, you run the crap out of your horse with a bunch of yahoos down a hill that's too steep and the ground is too soft and the horses trip and fall and roll and everybody's screaming and they think it's cool because they're a bunch of stupid yahoos. And anybody that knows me knows I'm not going to condone this. I don't like it and I think it's stupid. But somebody has to write me an email and ask me, please tell me what you think about the suicide race. I think you ought to join it without a horse. There's your answer to that. All right? Good grief, people bugging me. Let me go back to my little sign that gives me motivation. Alright, we'll end that there. Hope that helps. Bye-bye, team buddy. And I'm going to do another video after this on a horse about one rein riding. Anyway, hope that helps. We'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys.